Well, you saw the back garden, and now I'll show you what I'm doing with the front beds, or the lasagna garden. Not a lot, actually, but this is something we've added, is we're getting going on our composting, which is something I desperately need to do more of. And this is our new compost pile. It's right beside the raised beds. Before winter, we'll be transferring this pile, turning it over to this side, and then adding some more, I'm sure. And hopefully by next spring, I will have some good compost to add to the beds. The beds are pretty much sitting fallow right now. I harvested out all my spinach from this spring, and then I've just been trying to keep the weeds down and just kind of keep them open. I do want to do a fall garden up here. I'm trying to decide how I want to go about that, whether I want to concentrate on greens that are kind of cool or cold hardy and use row covers, or if I want to do root crops like beets and put straw and mulch over them. I've just got to decide what I want to do. I harvested a lot of seeds from these green onions, and also, if you remember, I had the collard greens over here that went to seed, and I harvested quite a bit of seeds. Let me show you a picture. So, I wonder if those would be good for sprouting. I still have the green onions in because I can pull a few at a time and use those, but they're coming out soon. I did buy two tomato plants from the farm store, grape tomato, obviously. And I like these for just fresh eating. If I have to get out here quick, though, because my kids keep a very close eye on how ripe these tomatoes are. And they're out here eating them almost faster than I can get to them, which is fine. I mean, who's going to complain about their kids eating tomatoes? And the other, so that's a grape, and then the other one is Mr. Stripey, and because everything's so late this year, I still have green tomatoes. I don't have any ripe ones. So hopefully they'll have a chance before fall. I also have a pepper plant up here, and he's not produced anything, not like the back garden. The carrots that are left from the spring, they're pretty decimated. Again, the kids have been out here eating on them, and again, I don't care. I had a lot of trouble with the Japanese beetles going after my new rhubarb. They don't touch the kind up at the house. They like this. So hopefully I got that licked. They're coming back. The strawberries, I don't know what I'm going to do with them. Next year will be their third year. I probably should replace them and maybe move them a different place. Oh, look at that big thistle right in the middle, or pokey bush or whatever. As I mentioned, the Japanese beetles were really doing a number on the rhubarb and also on my raspberries. I think I finally got on top of the problem. We hung those traps out, but they really did some damage. I had a really good early crop of raspberries, and I think the fall crop, which is usually the heaviest, is going to be excellent. The berries, as you can see, tend to be a little larger, and these are the ones I make jellies and stuff with, is the fall crop. We eat all the spring ones, and then I tend to do stuff with the other ones. So I'm looking forward to those coming ripe. There's another volunteer tomato in my asparagus of all places. Don't know how it got there. I dropped the ball on harvesting my parsnip seeds. I'm kind of mad at myself. I forgot about this plant out here. And I think all the seeds probably pretty much dropped off. I think these are just the husks. Maybe not. I don't know. But bummer. So I'm still trying to decide what to do with these beds. And I do want to do some fall gardening. I want to do some season extension gardening. I think Elliot Coleman, I'm getting the name right, he wrote the Four Season Harvest. And I have his books, I have several of his books, and I love his approach to gardening. He's a Maine gardener, and I want to try doing that. I think I need to do that.